explains that the word Aradhitaha refers to Srimati Radharani. He comments, the sage Sukadeva Goswami has tried with all endeavor to keep her name hidden, but now it automatically signs forth from the moon of his mouth. That he has spoken her name is indeed her mercy, and thus the word Aradhitaha is like the rumbling of a cauldron sounded to announce her great good fortune. Although the gopis spoke as if jealous of Srimati Radharani, they were actually ecstatic to see that she had captured Sri Krishna. Srila Krishna Chakravarti quotes the following detailed descriptions of Srimati Radharani's qualities as given by Srila Rupa Goswami in his Sri Ujjain Ramani. At the base of the large toe of her left foot is the mark of a body form. Below that mark is a disc. Below the disc is an umbrella. And below the umbrella is a crescent. A vertical line extends from the middle of her foot to the juncture of her large and second toes. At the base of the middle toe is a lotus. Below that is a flag with a banner. And below the flag is a creeper together with a flower. At the base of her small toe is an elephant gourd, and upon her heel is a half moon. Thus, there are elephant marks on her left foot. At the base of the large toe of her right foot is a conch shell, and below that a spear. At the base of the small toe of her right foot is a sacrificial altar, below that an earring, and below the earring a spear. Along the base of the second, third, fourth, and small toes is the mark of a mountain, below which is a chariot, and on the hill is a fish. Thus, altogether, there are 19 distinguishing marks on the soles of Srimati Radharani's lotus feet.
I think some part of it is Prabhupada's purport, others might be the devotees, as I know. So anyway, I rather get into what Mahabhagavat Prabhupada say, we don't know about Krishna even well. Krishna Tattva, I mean, appearance day, most auspicious day of Radharani. And somebody wrote to me here one question, Maharaj, what should we pray today? Very good question. Nitya Jogini Devi Dasi. Good question. What should we pray today? We should pray to Krishna. There is a prayer, Vandana, paying obeisance to Radharani. Everybody knows. Please chant with me. Sapta Kanchana Gaurangi Radhe Vrindavaneshwari Vrishabhanu Sute Devi Pranamami Hari Priye. Because she is dear most to Krishna, is very Krishna to approach difficult. But Radharani, his pleasure potency, who gives him pleasure. Of course, there is no difference ultimately to Krishna and Radharani. It's a very deep, something profound philosophy. And only liberated soul, they discuss this. But we can hear what they say. We can. So that, though you are doing, practicing devotional service, worshipping Radha Krishna is called Vidhi Bhakti. And in a liberated state, on the love of Godhead platform, we can release. Just Chaitanya Mahaprabhu will be Krishna, Radha Krishna's loving affairs, he'll be discussing with only 2 persons. One is Swarup Damodar and one is Raya Ramananda. They're highly elevated soul. And for that, to come to just like in the school college, Prabhupada said, you want to become master degree course study and become first class first, we have to pray for it. you have to qualify. Now, first we start with school, then if you do well, go to college, do well, then can go to university. So we are going, we have got at least ambition, we will go. Good, so we are here. In that mood, we are discussing what Prabhupada said. Don't know. I don't know how many of us, you know, realize Krishna. How many of us realize this body? Prabhupada said, when first we come to ISKCON, now I may be, say, 70, 71. I won't say I am free from bodily concept. Anybody is free from bodily concept? Please raise hand. Do you think you're trying to enjoy this body? You are not free. Anybody free from enjoying this body and lording over material nature? See our position. I said, I was talking with the professor. He said, everybody can keep become a pure devotee. Mahaprabhu said, it is open. It is open for everybody. Everybody can. But everybody won't at the same time. So why? Because he has to qualify. That is why we come here to get up early in the morning so that you can be in a mode of goodness. Without any mode of goodness, you don't get up early in the morning, don't do japa nicely, then how will you? Don't do austerity, following four relative principles, ultimately celibacy, brahmacharya. How we know this? It's not so easy. Anybody free from lusty desire? I am not. No, I frankly admit, if you are, very good. Anybody is free from lusty desire? This is first lesson, that is Bhagavad Gita. You become, then you become. Go to Srimad Bhagavatam. I mean deeply. Then Srimad Bhagavatam, then go to other, is Chaitanya Chaitamita. That is love of God at discussing. That is we understand. This is I am from Prabhupada telling. Just repeating. Prabhupada told one, hey, preach. I don't know what to preach in front of you. Just repeat what I say. So I am saying that. I am not teaching anybody. Take it like that. Not teaching. I am just repeating what Prabhupada said so that by serving Prabhupada, I become purified. By practicing. You pray for me. So we pray to Radharani. We pray today. Because he is dearest to Krishna and she is very soft-hearted. And Vrindavan, Brajavasi, you will find many of you must have gone to Vrindavan. I may go soon, maybe. But this is also a very deep subject, Vrindavan. What is Vrindavan? Vrindavan, Mathura means Krishna's pastime place. And Mathura means where Krishna is born. According to our Acharya's top, you can study, you know, arithmetic, mathematics in primary school, also higher school, even up to a master degree, you can do. And there is no end to it. If it is material, it's like that. Knowledge, what to speak of spiritual? This is paravidya or avidya or paravidya. And that is paravidya, parabhukti. That is beyond. That we are still in, we are chanting, Om Ajnana Timirandhasya. We are in ignorance. We come here to do perform devotional service. But we are doing devotional service. Have you got material desire? In the primary stage, we have. If we become giving up this material desire or free from false ego of I am this, I am that, this too has to go to become rendering pure devotional service. Unless we do pure devotional service, come to. How can we understand all this thing? But it's very good. At least we are not like outside people. In that scale, we are trying to become Vaishnava, to go to Vishnu, Krishna. Krishna, more difficult. Krishna. We are worshipping Radha Krishna. Actually, anybody knows we are doing Vidhi Bhakti. This is what Prabhupada says. Vidhi Bhakti. Vidhi Bhakti means following rule, regulation. You are not liberated. But one day you may be fortunate to become liberated spontaneously. We are lacking to come Mangalarati, come to Harikatha, and like it. And hear from advanced Sadguru or Mahabhagavat, then we can, within our heart, we can feel that Krishna will appear. And that is Vrindavan also. Otherwise, going to Vrindavan, in one sense, yes, but I am looking for sense object, where is Vrindavan, nice. Don't mind. Rabdi, go to Lohi Bazar. Or Kochuri, don't mind. It is nice. No, you cannot then. You cannot see Krishna. Krishna is there. Radhana is there. Krishna is there. Radhana. Still, their pastime is going on. But one who has Vishwaya Charya Kavi Shuddha Veman, one whose mind and consciousness become purified of running after sense object, then heart become, consciousness become purified. Kavi Hama Herava Sri Vrindavan. Then by Lord's grace, we can feel the, realize Vrindavan, we can realize Krishna. Radharani is far away. First know Krishna. Radhani means you are a great personality. You can know, he give you a card. I'm telling from Prabhupada. He give you a card, you know, his name is managing director, this. Big guy, multimillionaire, he has got card, this, that. And go to him, he's the Darwan. Tell him, hey. You know, you see a sadhu. What to speak of, where he get delight. What he enjoys, that he won't talk to you. You can get a card, you go to office, talk to him, business, this, that. Not that his private life. That his private life is he has got his wife, he has got his children. That is his private life. So Radharani means like that. That is Krishna's personal. Why you get into Krishna's personal? You cannot. We have to be qualified. This is deep philosophy. The Prabhupada discuss what you are telling. We are mostly outside people in a mode of passion and ignorance. He is only thinking, I am this body. He cannot think anything beyond this body. So only he is running after bodily, which give pleasure immediately to body. Simply running after that. That means stung and other sensual pleasure he is after. How can he know? He won't listen even, all these things. But we have still, we may have simply this tendency also. Though you are eating prasad, very good, gradually we are better than them. But outside people, what is their future, is difficult to say. Because they are leading a life more or less pasubhi samana. He says, this is almost like animals, most of the people. It is just a so-called advancement mean, Prabhupada said, is polished, coat, pant, shirt, tip-top, inside is like a dog. Very sensual pleasure. That is what modern civilization advancement is. Person, no, our method is not that. Our method is follow the great Mahajan, their instruction. Then we can release. We can know Krishna in tattvata. Then after that, when you become in a liberated state, that's called rag-marga. Rag means attachment, concentrated attachment. Very strong attachment. That is bhava, then raga, roti. At that time, we can discuss this. Otherwise, we'll take it very cheaply. It's not very unlikely to hear some people saying, joking with Radha Krishna in terms of Radha Krishna, husband, wife, young boy, young girl. They are called sahajya. The very word sahaj means easy. They take it easy. That is why they always discuss Ras Lila, Radha Krishna, and big thing, without becoming at heart pure. Still lusty desire there, they're thinking. And so they go far, far away from Krishna consciousness. Apparently look like. And the Bhaktivinoda Thakur told them, as long as you are enjoying spirit with this body, mind, gross and subtle. He used some word, little strong, it's called Kali Chela. Don't mind. Here, Kali Chela. Kali personified his followers. Yeah. Only after saints get here. Your tilak, mala, all these things. By that, you cannot externally know a Vaishnava. Vaishnava is different. He has quality there, he has, you know, symptom there, external, internal, and he can release. Better to follow Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's follower. How? Come to Vairagya Vidya Nija Bhakti Yoga. Am I become detached from materialistic way of life, of running after wealth, running after sensual pleasure, and follower, many name, fame, position, then you cannot. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, only expect only to serve under the guidance Krishna, Mahaprabhu, under the guidance of a pure devotee, Sadguru. Then gradually, by their mercy, the Guru's power, ordinary Guru is Radharani, is top devotee, he is the embodiment of devotional service. So, if you can please him, she is very soft-hearted. As Krishna has got expansion, she has expansion. Many Lalita, Vishakha, so many other names there, they are all mentioned in different Vedic literature. Of course, not Srimad Bhagavatam, slightly. So our acharyas, they intentionally they do that because it's a question of qualification. So we see it this way, through the eye of scripture, through the eyes of sadhu, mahatma, those are qualified, like Prabhupada. So I'm little bit reading, telling what Prabhupada says about that. So we have to come to that platform, going beyond mode of passion and ignorance. Every time we should be in a mode of goodness. Try to see. One day one devotee was asking Prabhupada, you see, we have got this quality of superiority complex. Who could be greater than me? I am top devotee. And others also. I get angry easily. Pride, arrogance, enviousness. Person, listen. If you are doing really devotional service, within a short time, this should disappear. If you really doing that. Oh, but many of us have got this. Yes, but gradually it will go away. You try. So, but I'm just repeating what Prabhupada said, you know. Best is follow the footprints of the Goswamis. Our Goswamis, even previously, the King Bharat said, he was the emperor of this world. And one time, there are many, many examples in India, one time, at the age of 24, he is emperor. And gave up, in India, is naturally, in a royal family, there is always for the king, for the prince, for enjoyment. There are beautiful ladies, princess there, in the palace, sing, dance, to give pleasure to the king or the prince. When they come to know about the higher pleasure there, they gave up. Just as if some refuse of our body. At once, at the age of 24, Devika, a man, a young man from the age of, as I understand from Prabhupada, the age of, what Prabhupada told me, from the age of Subhag, say, 16 or 18 to 25, mind is very turbulent. All these things Prabhupada discussed, that is what I am saying. Yes or no? Yeah? Sometimes you eat agitating food, too much sweet, all these things. Sometimes more, maybe even. So how old are you? Well, I am 28. How you feel? Your urges. But as we go older, if we control, try to become slightly less maybe, otherwise. So think of. And some other gender from the around the age of, please excuse me, what Prabhupada said, 12 to 14. Very tolerant. Very tolerant. And so it is said, crap! Lusty desire. And when you can turn lusty desire into love, then you achieve perfection. I don't know if somebody is fortunate can say, now I have. Prabhupada once was telling in Delhi airport. So, do you know how everybody is running after me? Why? Give up sex desire. This is brahmachari life. Then sannyasi. It is extremely difficult. If somebody asks me, I am telling something practical, don't mind. Somebody asks me, this is also Radharani's kotha, master qualification, telling background. I think if I become 80, still I will think, shall I take sannyas? I am telling you, opening my heart actually. Maharaj, you have got last year, anytime I come. But you pray for me so that I don't become victim. So Radharani is far away. So Brajubasis, they, Vrindavan means they live very simple. Sometimes devotee asks Prabhupada, so many ladies and old men in Vrindavan Prabhupada, severe cold, heat, they are tolerating. They must have got some Radharani's mercy. You can? We all fly away. Somebody come from cold place, when it's hot, now Vrindavan, I just ask him, he coming from Vrindavan. How many devotees? Many gone. When there's little cold, very nice, then they all come. This is not Vrindavan. Those who can tolerate all these things, you have to understand, has got some mercy of. Because this is called tapasya. This is called tapasya. Tapasya, brahmacharjena, samena, dhamena. Prabhupada mentioned. Are we controlling our senses, our mind? This is for the. Why? Others are controlling. So many. Give up everything, kick out the Goswamis, the king. Why? Bhakti Parishanu Babu. He has got higher taste. He has got higher taste. How he here? Some maybe there are many years. He must have some taste, otherwise you cannot stay in devotional service. You must have some higher taste. Otherwise you cannot give up. Materialistic way of life, running after wealth, running after sensual pleasure, name, fame, subtle, all these things, followers. You must be. Otherwise you cannot. Unless you get a higher taste. It's a date. Just to have little Brahma Sukh, spiritual pleasure, ananda, bliss, they kick out all these things. Live very simple life. They are living very simple life. Every morning, evening going, Mangalarti, evening arti, listening Harikatha. That's why Prabhupada introduced that. Every day, come to Srimad Bhagavatam class. Everybody must. And evening, go to Bhagavad Gita class. And digest it. And implement it in your life. Mold your life in such a way, in such that you become, your life become personification of teachings of Bhagavad Gita, teachings of Srimad Bhagavatam. What is teaching of Bhagavatam? The person, you are Bhagavat. Yeah, Bhagavan. Then you experience higher pleasure. You can tell. So I cannot tell. I'm just telling what Prabhupada said. You are trying. How do you say? So this is Jiva Goswami saying. This is the point we should think. So Krishna, who is Parabrahma, Paramdhama, Pavitram, Paramam Bhavam. He is Parabrahma. We may be Brahma, but we have not realized. Otherwise, why will we be running after material pleasure, gross. You realize, then the symptom will be different. It will be different, external, internal. Brahma-bhuta-prasannātmā. Devotees are usually joyful. That is something he achieved. They are bright faces. Because outsiders are like hogs and dogs. They are going to become next dog. Living like hogs. We are not living like hogs. Getting up, look bright face. Getting up early in the morning, take bath. They don't take bath. Even in Siberia, our devotees taking bath, I heard. Cold weather, taking bath. Even little kids, Mataji, taking bath. So they won't be pure? Of course. That is Rishabhdev say. Tapodibvam putraka, do tapasya. Voluntarily accept some inconvenience. Who likes to in severe cold take bath? In Western countries, all devotees are taking bath in cold. Everybody knows here, many sitting here. It's not easy. Other people don't do. Maybe in a week sometime, take one's bath. That is also warm water. Going to swimming pool, watch. I went also. Forgive him. Sauna. Prabhupada say, don't do hot bath. Just associating for a brahmachari, sannyasi, taking bath like this, forbidden. He's just having, breaking rule regulation, one of the four. Of course, you have got reason, some severe, you know, you have got fever or something. Case is different. So, tapodibvam putchaka, why? To, so that your existence is purified. Purified. Why existence want to do existence purified? Why you want to make your existence purified? Want to? Jasmat brahma sukham is anantam. You can bet unlimited. Beginning, unlimited. No end. Spiritual bliss, ananda. And that is why everybody, so many karma yogi, jnana yogi, trying to do yoga. Yoga means ramante yoginam anante. Material pleasure, taking something palatable, I don't want to mention, so many we like. After reading, chapala sukala valagire, momentary pleasure. Even highest material world pleasure, everybody think, oh, heavenly pleasure. Man, woman's physical pleasure. After that, no. But this is unending, unlimited. Can think of, if it's for this, they kick out. They gave up their family, they gave up their attachment. To children, kingdom, name, fame, nothing. Kick out. King Bharat, even Lord Buddha. He was a prince. So many beautiful ladies associated within the palace. He's supposed to be next king. He can do whatever he like. He gave up. He gave up. Living simple, going out. For a king's son, prince, leader, it's not an easy thing. He understood. He understood. Oh, this is temporary pleasure. After that, I have to die. I'll suffer disease, this, that. I'm king. I cannot be free from all this. Even becoming king, even becoming prince. His father don't want him, that he sees all these things. Father understood. Don't take my son there. So many kings, big, big personalities in India, thousands of examples there. It's all what Prabhupada said, I'm telling you. There, they did that. Take path of austerity. So, the point is, Jiva Goswami said, point is, so Krishna is a supreme spirit, he is part of Brahma. Will he be after? He is not an ordinary person. Only those are fool. Abhujananti, ma mura, manusim tanumastam. Because Krishna took a human-like body, they think maybe Krishna is maybe little better than us. No. He is Satchidananda Vigraha. His body is embodiment. He is the embodiment of eternity, knowledge and bliss. Our is temporary. any moment, accident, stroke, finish, this is lump of matter. He is the Supreme Spirit, whole body is spirit. Our body, we are now changing body every time, and we forget, even Arjuna saying like that. How can you remember everything? Oh, Krishna's body is not changing. He is, even grandfather says 120 years, 25. But he looks like a 16-year-old boy. We may not be like that, at least devotees associated with Krishna in the form of name, Harikatha, at least they look bright-faced, not so much suffering, which is a stage of liberation. We are one day will become completely liberated. Then we can release Radha Krishna laughing affairs. Now we can little bit discuss. Prabhupada said, little bit discuss. Because we are on the path on liberation. Liberation means attanta dukkha nibritti. You become free from dukkha, distress. Our devotees are bright faces. It's not artificial. How are you? Good morning. Fine. I'm fine. It's not like that, our devotees. The face tells. Unless they are joyful, how can they chant and dance for a long time? They cannot, even cassius can come, little, our Dara Singh, little jumping and then stop. They see us. Prabhupada said this thing. They are dancing, chanting, ISKCON devotees, like a peacock coming from Vaikuntha. Why? They are feeling some joy. That joy is divine, that is spiritual. That is spiritual. So they are here, you see, all bright faces. Of course, we are still not completely liberated. When you become more mature in the path of liberation, then you can release Krishna for that. Now we can release at least prasad. Yeah? Everybody release prasad? This much at least we have. We can release Harinam. That is almost perfect. Haridas Thakur. And still there are people there, whole day not eating, not going to even attend nature's call. What he is releasing? Simply chanting. We cannot artificially do that. But at least we can know, get up early in the morning, take bath, and early in the morning finish japa. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna. Now one day maybe we can. We are cutting down our sleeping, cutting down other enjoyment because we are getting pleasure. That is what Prabhupada is saying. Get up early in the morning. Finish your job as early as possible. That is the best time. Other daytime you are doing that is not Hare Krishna, and so many mind other places attracted. This is not japa. You are not associating this. None of us are realistic. It is just a, you have to finish your round, you are thinking like this. Nonsense. Goswami is did job. That is why Goswami said, when I will chant the holy name, I feel like releasing so much. I have got millions of tongue. Then I could have done a little bit. Rupa Goswami. And goes in the ear, is so like a tasting nectar. I have got millions of ears. I could release little. Now we are trying to finish. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Rama. Huh? You have to finish. That's good. This is not Rama. Better do some service to Krishna. Do some service to Prabhupada, what Prabhupada said. Go out, distribute book, and exhaust. Some do other service, 24 hours serve. Even sleeping, just to keep the body fit, you require little sleep, you sleep that much. Prabhupada will be sleeping 11 to 1, sometimes, usually. After breakfast, I gave Prabhupada many times breakfast. Prabhupada, 1 hour, take rest. Noon time, I also give Prabhupada breakfast. Noon prasad, 1 hour rest, not more. Even resting time, at night Prabhupada also, still thinking, before he sleep, thinking, how to improve service, how to expand. This is, we have to learn. When that day will come? Kabe habe bolo sedin amar. When I will forget my bodily demand, Dehavuddhi Nahijar Sangsar Vandaknath. He is a liberated soul who has forgot bodily all demands. How he can forget? He forget getting higher pleasure beyond mind. That he can. That is what Prabhupada is saying. That is Raga Marga. That is Mahamarga. That is then he is in a master degree course. Otherwise, we know Manushyanam Sahasreshu, out of thousands of thousands, millions of people. One try to achieve perfection. Siddha. Siddha means perfection. He's free from all material distress. How many of us? At least most of the devotees are much more free from distress compared to outside people. Yes? Yes? Usually. Why? They are doing austerity. That is why, naturally. They'll get some pleasure within. That is why they are. They don't get that much disease. That much danger. If at all, save. I've seen many cases, there's some accident, everybody dies. Came out one boy, found out he's gone, devotee, little he has got hurt here. That's all guy died, severely injured, going to die. Going to Bodrinath, and he was supposed to be a president of a small temple. Surprise. Another devotee, he's going, Bodrinath, going in a bus. And bus, sometimes very narrow path, going a little bit out of the road. That means you don't know where the bottom is, where the end is. Cannot see, get nervous. Driver trying to reverse. Everybody voice, dry up. One devotee, girl, she is ISKCON devotee. She's saying, please chant Hare Krishna. She is not scared. Chanting, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Conductor even voice died. He cannot even trying to bell. Ding, ding. Reverse. And driver is trying. After a long time, nobody, please chant. Nobody can. It's out of fear. They all die every year. But the devotee, peaceful, is not so scared. He's chanting, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. See, no, any moment you can die. So what? I chant Hare Krishna. And actually, Krishna responded. Time passing, passing. Every moment appears to be like a long time not passing. Days, weeks, months not passing. Feeling. That girl, young girl, is gone devotee. She is telling her experience. At one point, still they are not chanting, and she is chanting. Then everybody accepted. Because she chanted, they came. I can tell another story. There is a news I had. When there is atomic bomb was dropped in Nagasaki and Hiroshima, everything disappeared. I heard there is one monastery or church. They chant always either Mother Mary or God's name, you know, chant. So they were asked, how you survive? They say, only we know this way we survive. Nothing happened to them. We are always chanting the holy name of God. Can you see how powerful the holy name? That is why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, Namna Makari Bhuda Nija Sarva Shakti. All Krishna's omnipotence is there in his name, but we are not chanting purely. You are chanting offense. With offense, somebody clearing offense. No, when you come to like that stage, Haridas Thakur, or what Prabhupada said. One Prabhupada's disciple said, we had some problem to our managers are not agreeing how to run. And we have gone to Prabhupada to complain. What solution? We saw Prabhupada sitting in his room. Prabhupada knows they have come. Positive. They hear. They sat down, they hearing, boys, sit down, boys chanting, ask them also chant, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna. After some time, Prabhupada said, come. They said, Prabhupada, why you came? To solve our problem, we have got some difference of opinion, how to run, manage. Prabhupada, this is all gone. So chant nicely, Prabhupada. We are sharing with Krishna. So Prabhupada, I remember, he used to tell us, you have got problem? Go in front of deity, Krishna is there. Chant in front of him. Nicely. You'll find all your problems, Krishna is there. Yeah. You have to have faith. You have to have implicit faith. That the Goswamis had. They learned from the Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is nothing. Krishna became Radha Krishna to in order to enjoy loving exchange, relish. Just a man gets married to a person. Have a wife and expand, children, this, that, loving father, mother, all together. It's another, it's a gross example. And Krishna also expand. Radharani also expand. So many gopis and doing Raslila, this, that. We cannot enter into this mystery. Roughly you can know, maybe little greedy, you want to know one day. So roughly we can know this thing. So Krishna does not enjoy some material, neither pleasure, neither Radharani is a young girl, neither Krishna is a young boy. His activity, he is doing everything. He does not do directly. Even in the material world, a big guy who was saying, he doesn't do himself anything. He enjoys with his family. But he has got, his wife also has got many assistants, servants, this, that they are doing. They don't hardly do anything. But everything gets done. Krishna also like that. Radharani also like that. Huh? So Radharani is not an ordinary girl. We think our wife, our mother, sister, daughter, not like that we should think. She is also born. So Prabhupada is saying, when a king has not got children, and a queen also, so one day he was plowing in the field, he found one baby girl. This is the today Krishna birthday of Krishna's pleasure potency. This is like that, Prabhupada said. She appeared like that. Not like any girl or a boy is born from the womb of his mother, not like that. As Krishna. Krishna is Aja. He doesn't take birth like others. He appears. So Radhana is also like that. What is the difference between Radhana and Krishna? Only difference is subtle. That is like fire and heat. They are non-different at the same time, same. We can't think of fire without heat. Neither you can think of heat unless there is fire. So Krishna means also Radharani there. Wherever there is Krishna, there is Radharani. Where is Radharani? There is Krishna. They are always enjoying like that. We can at least this much we can know. And if we want to know what they are enjoying, we can follow the footprints of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came himself to show us how to do that. How to know Krishna, how to know Radharani. Developing his method is that develop some feeling of separation, vipralamba, from Krishna. We are something now different. Feeling, I don't have this, I want to enjoy. This is most of us have got this. As long as you transfer that attachment to love, serving Radharani, serving Krishna, then by their master, he says, Ata Sri Krishna Namadi no Bhavet Grajan Vindyoy. We cannot understand Krishna's name, form, beauty, pastime. That is transcendental. There is no difference between that and Krishna or Radharani. When you serve, becoming pleased with our surrender and service attitude, they reveal within our heart. Krishna appears within our heart. And Krishna's Leela, you can see. Who? That is who has got love. Premanjana churita bhakti bilochan, you know, shanta, that sadhu, sadaiva, always in the television of his heart can see Radha Krishna Leela. Right now we are seeing something maybe different. Yeah? Because we are in a material plane. Little advanced, maybe in the mental plane. These are all matter. Sometimes chidabhas, in between matter and spirit. Beyond that mind is spirit. We have to come to spiritual platform. That is called Brahma-bhuta-prasanna-atma. We are enjoying Brahma-sukha. Ittam-sadam Brahma-sukha-anubhutta. After many practice of this, we can do Brahma-sukha, giving up all this, running after material pleasure, temporary. Brahma-sukha, spiritual happiness. This is what Krishna enjoys. He doesn't enjoy material thing. That's called pleasure potency. Center of this is Radharani. Krishna's pleasure potency expansion is all the gopis. That is why the Brahma, when he realizes, he says, the ananda chinmaya rasa pratibhavita abhi. Ananda chinmaya rasa, mellow of the spiritual, transcendental or spiritual pleasure potency. Center is Radharani. And expansion are gopis, different, major gopis. So Krishna play with them, dance with them. Whole Vrindavan is like that, Krishna's, whole expansion of Krishna's present potency. But they are the chief, they are the chief. And Radha is the embodiment. That's why he slightly mentioned, because we are not qualified, you understand, Sukadev Goswami, little bit on our Aradito today, saying, Anaya Baihar Aradito. Nobody can please Krishna so much as one gopi. That gopi is Radha. So we cannot at once jump into this, then we will become Sahajya. But we have got a little greed, so we know this, so that we can one day become perfectly liberated, we can rag marga bhajan, we can do. Otherwise we run after gopi bhav, rasik bhakta, edige, I am enjoying material rasa, we will become Sahajya. Hopefully our devotees are not like that, most of us. They follow Prabhupada, this is a very good sign. We should follow what the Goswamis did. There is mention. Other places mentioned that to show that the Rupa Goswami said, Radhe Jayo Jayo Madhava Doite Gokula Toruni Mandala Mohite Damodara Roti Bardhana Beshe Hori Niskuta Vinda Vipineshe. It simply means, Prabhupada is saying, to understand Radha Krishna's love, he is saying, all glories to Radhe, Jai Radhe, Jai Radha Madhava. Prabhupada once in Kumbh Mela, suddenly he is chanting that, he is singing that song, Jai Radha Madhava, and devotee saw Prabhupada stop. He is overwhelmed in ecstasy. For 5 minutes or some time, he didn't say anything. Then devotees later asked, Prabhupada, what happened? Prabhupada said, exactly this is happening in the spiritual world. You have to qualify yourself, to be fortunate to see all this. So he's saying, so you are most dear to Krishna. Krishna praying is so valuable, but Krishna is, we are after, everybody is after Krishna. Krishna is most attractive. You have to understand what gives Krishna pleasure. That is Radha. And he is after Radha. He is after Radha. Because why? Yajo Madhava Radha. That is why Bhujavasi always want the mercy of Radhani. Jai Radhe, they say. We say Jai Krishna. We Jai Radha, you don't say. Prabhupada says, no, this is not our mood. They are Bhujavasi's mood. They can follow. We more into Radha Krishna. She always dressed so nicely that Damodar Krishna becomes attracted by her beauty. Hari Niskuta Vrinda Vipineshi. She is the only lovable object of Krishna. Only lovable. She is the queen of Vrindavan. You go to Vrindavan, everybody is worshipping Radharani. He is the queen. Rani means queen. And he's saying, so we, as she asked me, he's saying, Rupa Goswami is praying, Koruna Kurumuhi, Koruna Bharite. Oh, my worshipful Radharani, you are full of mercy. So I offer, I am begging of your mercy because you are so merciful. Very easily, Koruna. Tapta Kanchana Gaurangi, Radhe Vrindavaneshwari, Vishwabhanu Sute Devi Pranamami Harpi. Easily you Koruna Bharite, Sanaka Sanatana Bhurcharite. Now somebody may say, oh, you are so great, learned scholar, you are so great, saintly person, you are begging mercy from an ordinary girl. No, how can she be ordinary? Why? Because even the greatest, you know, the brahmacharis, like the greatest devotee, the girls, description is only possible by made by saintly person like Sanak Sanatan. They are great brahmachari, but they are very old, look like little boy. So she is not an ordinary girl, you shouldn't think. So the lesson is that we should not treat Radhani as an ordinary girl or Krishna as an ordinary man. The supreme absolute truth. Their supreme absolute truth. Together, Krishna. And when they become two is Radha Krishna, again become one as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So we have to follow as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's Goswamis did, giving up the association of aristocracy. People You are big ministers, like a mad person giving up all those wealth with a simple living in Vrindavan, going to find out where the Krishna's pastimes, Radharani's pastimes, and didn't they see Krishna? But they are always saying, Hey Radhe Brajadevi ke Talolite, oh, where are you, Radharani? Are you on the foothills of Govardhan or on the bank of Kalindi? Where are you, Lalita? Where are you, Visakha? Where are you, Nandasuna, darling of Nanda Maharaj? Where are you? Teaching us how to feel, develop feeling of separation from Krishna. Is it that Prabhupada said they didn't see Krishna? No, they saw. Krishna appears to them. How to? Then Bhakti-sandarbha Thakur says, don't try to see Krishna. Qualify yourself. Better surrender to Krishna under the guidance of pure devotee. And with a service attitude, humble, go on serving. You serving such nicely and surrendering that Krishna one day will be pleased.